What do run-of-river power plants do during floods? Floods are natural events, only slightly influenced by power plants located on rivers. While storage power plants can take up water to a limited extent, this is not an option for run-of-river plants. During the permit procedure for a run-of-river power plant, great care is taken to ensure that the river's natural state, that is, the state before the construction of the power plant, is altered as little as possible. This means that run-of-river power plants are not flood control systems. They can, however, minimize or prevent flooding in the area around their dikes. When large amounts of water cause the water level below the dam to rise, the power plant reduces its electricity generation, even as far as completely halting its turbines. The hydraulic head is no longer sufficient to drive the turbine blades. Otherwise remotely operated, the power plant control rooms are manned by personnel around the clock during floods, so that they can respond quickly to any possible incident. For each power plant, there is a set of officially authorized operational instructions, the so-called Rules of Weir Operation. These rules clearly regulate the water levels to be operated in the impoundment area, on the Danube, the Austrian-Bavarian border stretch of the Inn, and on the Drava River east of Villach. The Ministry of Life's Supreme Water Authority is responsible for the approval of weir operation rules. In order to determine how the hydropower plant should be operated, the following water level measurements are taken: the head water level directly at the power plant, and the water level at a control gauge in the impoundment area, or a gauge at the upstream end of the impoundment. Every power plant has a design discharge, which is the maximum amount of water that the turbines can process in order to generate electricity. If this amount of water is surpassed, weirs must be opened in order to manage the additional discharge from the impoundment area. By opening weirs, the headwater level, that is, the area upstream of the power plant, can be lowered in order to avoid inundations worse than prior to the power plant's construction. Thus, for a short time, the water outflow from the impoundment slightly exceeds its inflow. During extreme flood events, the water level corresponds to the situation prior to the construction of the power plant. Run-of-river power plants don't have reservoir lakes to retain massive quantities of water. This leads to a phenomenon. Despite the flood, the headwater level of the power plant sinks, sometimes even leaving boats stranded. When the flooding subsides, the power plants close their weirs again. The headwater level slowly returns to its normal value. For a short time, the amount of outflow from the impoundment is a bit lower than the inflow. During flood events, official crisis management measures take effect. The federal provinces' hydrographic surveys are responsible for flood warnings, and to that end, receive online water level data from the power plant gauges. Verbund. Power for the future.